He gonna wipe the floor with him.
Well, he is indeed, and of course, you got quite a match coming up, too, with the Assassin.
With the Assassin? I'm going to take care of the Assassin. Everybody know the reputation of the Assassin. But this man right here, something got to be done for him. And I'm going to be in Tony Atlas' corner. Whatever you want me to do, any advice to get rid of this man so he can turn his face and be ashamed for the rest of his life.
Thank you so very much. Remember, all of this action takes place Friday night, November 14th at the Omni in Atlanta, match time 8:30.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match will be one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first from Minneapolis, Minnesota, weighing in at 249 pounds, Ole Anderson. His opponent from Canada, weighing in at 232 pounds, Jerry Roberts.
Jerry Roberts going up against Ole Anderson. And it's Anderson closing in very quickly. Roberts into that turnbuckle, getting Roberts again up against the ring ropes, whips him off the far side, caught him with an elbow, coming off the ropes. Lateral press, but Roberts powered out before the count of three. Roberts escaping from a rear chin lock. Anderson trying to float over. Roberts back on his feet. Now Roberts has that right hand cocked. I can't blame him. Roberts now using that right hand very effectively. Anderson, hurdle to the far side. Wow. Anderson caught him with a flat of the foot coming in. Full body slam by Ole Anderson. Anderson down, an elbow across the chest. It is Anderson using the knee effectively to the side of the head of Jerry Roberts. And again, Anderson using the flat of the foot. Roberts powers out, however, using a hard right hand. A rear chin lock now by Ole Anderson. Anderson's keeping that rear chin lock now on Jerry Roberts. And it is Roberts firing one to the midsection, two, and then three, and fourth one. And it is Anderson now being caught repeatedly by Jerry Roberts, and Anderson being beaten back. Anderson brought up a full body slam. Anderson powering out before the count of three. Another one to the midsection. One right squarely on the ear. And that can do a lot to destroy the sense of balance immediately. Anderson brings him out. Vertical souffle. Count of three. Count of three. Ole Anderson using a vertical souffle and using it very effectively indeed. And so Jerry Roberts goes down in defeat to one half of the Minnesota Wrecking Crew, Ole Anderson, who had a lot of things to say just a few moments ago.
Disgusting. Sitting out here talking to a guy like Candy, talking about somebody like Atlas. I'm the only man that deserves that Georgia taggie, Georgia trophy, Georgia championship belt. Me.
Indeed.
I deserve them all, Gordon.
Well, I'll tell you what. Before we go any farther, Mr. Anderson, I would like very much for you to hear some previously recorded comments from one Tony Atlas.
I gotta sit here and listen to Atlas? I just got through listening to Candy. I don't need Atlas either.
Well, we're going to hear those comments from Tony Atlas nonetheless, so these were recorded earlier.
Congratulations, Tony Atlas, on being the Georgia heavyweight wrestling champion.
You know, a whole lot of people had held this belt before me and everything, and I never realized exactly what the Georgia belt was all about because I never had the belt. You know, if you ain't never had nothing, you really don't know what it's all about. I knew the belt was prestige. I knew it was the next belt. Whoever is a Georgia champion is right in line for the world's title. Now, Ole Anderson had did a whole lot of jaw-jacking for a long time about winning the Georgia belt. I don't know if Ole Anderson ever was the Georgia champ, but Ole Anderson realized the prestige that go along with this belt. Ole Anderson, if you want this belt, brother, anytime you want this belt, you just get your butt on out here and you just try to take this belt, Ole Anderson, and I would shove it down your throat so deep you would think in one of your organs you was born with. Ole Anderson, there's no way in the world that you would take this belt from me, because first of all, Ole Anderson, you are a no-good, low-down, good-for-nothing dog. That's all you ever been. That's all you ever will be. You turn on your brother. You turn on Dusty Rhodes. I'm not going to give you the chance to turn on me, Ole Anderson. You will not get the belt. I won't let you get the belt. The only thing you're going to get, brother, is a fat lip and a black eye, and I ain't worried about you giving me neither one of them things.
Now, Friday the 14th, you got that title up against Ole at the
Omni. Friday the 14th, Ole Anderson, you bring yourself to the Omni. A young girl told me one time, said, Ole Anderson, he don't care nothing for black people. Ole Anderson think of black people and be something like you ran with Trigger. You know, that's how Ole Anderson look at us. You know what I'm saying? But Ole Anderson, I ain't none of one name, one of them things.
Well, there you have it, the comments from Tony Atlas, the Georgia heavyweight champion. And next week, we'll be presenting him as the Black Athlete of the Year. And truly,
there's no way in the world, Gordon Sully, that he or anybody else is going to be presented any kind of award. He'll be over more.
What do you mean he'll be? Oh.
Tony Atlas. Tony Atlas, you're a gutless son of a gun. You won't even come down here to get your own award. I'm going to get your belt. Friday night when I get to that Omni, I'm going to stop all the awards, all the black athletes of the year. Sit on, please. I'm going to stop all the awards, all the black athletes of the year. I'm going to take you apart, Tony Atlas, and I'm going to take your belt. Just show up. Shine it up. Get it all ready. And I'm going to take it from you at the Omni.
Well, I don't know what to say. I really don't.
We've got millions of fans across the country waiting all week to see this, and now the procrastination is beginning to get under my skin. Now, if Sullivan doesn't realize what is going on, then he's just as stupid as he looks. The guy sent the telegram. He realized his error, and he wanted to apologize and save himself humiliation. He's not going to be here. Let's get the match. Hey, come here, man. Hey, come here. Look, he's not going to be here. Now, this is getting monotonous. Let's get it on.
Hey, Gordon, the man gave me his word he'll be here. I just like a few more minutes, and he'll be here.
How stupid are you? He's not going to be here.
Gordon, I'd like to wait a few more minutes. Gordon, I'll tell you one thing. The man gave me his word that he'll be here. I believe in the man. I believe he'll be here. All I want is a few more minutes.
All right. That certainly seems plausible enough. Let me, I just mention while we do have a second here, may I just mention that next week you're on Georgia Championship Wrestling for the first time ever, a girls' battle royal. That's right. A girls' battle royal here on Georgia Championship Wrestling. We'll be back on our regular time, by the way, from 6 until 8 p.m. That's 6 until 8 p.m. And another interesting fact, too, that we mentioned in the during an earlier hour is the fact that Judy Martin and Joyce Grable, who entered the Thanksgiving annual tag team tournament that has, over the past, been normally reserved for men only, they have been accepted. So they will be, in fact, in action in that tournament coming up on Thanksgiving. But
with father-son wrestling team of Bob and Brad Armstrong. Brad has been in pro wrestling only a short time now, and Brad, you've already suffered a major shoulder separation, and I'd like to ask you what that has done toward your attitude of pro wrestling.
Well, Charlie, I've been in a great deal of pain recently, and it's made me sit back and think a lot about professional wrestling. Dad told me how tough it was. He said, son, it's double tough, and it has been. And I still love the wrestling business, and I think I'll continue as soon as my shoulder heals.
Bob, I know you're proud of Brad and his career so far. He's had an outstanding win record, but I know this also could be bothersome to you.
That's right. Professional wrestling is a very tough sport. And if people remember, just a few weeks ago, he made a challenge to Mr. Saito, who's offering all this money to somebody that can beat him in a certain amount of time. Brad wasn't ready for him. He's not ready for him now, but he's talked to me constantly. Dad, I want to try it. I want to try it. I want to try Mr. Saito, the big mouth man from Japan, the man who thinks he can do it all, the Olympic champion who has beaten people from east to west. And I've told Brad, okay, brother, it's up to you. You get this shoulder well, and you can give it a whirl. But I am sick to death of hearing Saito run down American wrestlers. You know, we've got Olympic champions, too. Look at Dan Gable. He won a gold medal with one eye popped out so big that he couldn't even see, and he won a gold medal. Americans are tough, are double tough. We play catch-as-catch-can wrestling. It's a little bit different. And one of these days, Saito, you're going to find out exactly how different it is, brother, because you can be beaten just like anybody else. Whether I can do it, whether my son can do it, somebody's going to come along, take your money and the time limit. So just don't forget, your day is coming. Every dog has his day, Saito. And I'm here to tell you, you're just the dog to have your day, believe me.
Well, may I just add, too, that I talked to Bob Armstrong on the telephone just about 30 minutes ago, and he informed me that next week he, Bob Armstrong, will be here to face Mr. Saito in the ring for the $5,000 challenge.
Sullivan is here.
Mike Davis with Austin Idol as the special referee, but to date, Austin Idol has failed to appear, and the Freebirds claim that he will not be here.
Freebirds Fantasia. You know, Gordon Sully, you really, let me get over here so we can get all of our beautiful bodies in there. You really can't blame a man because it takes a big man to realize when he's made a mistake and own up to it. And the man has saved himself so much embarrassment that's going to come down on Kevin Sullivan, so much humiliation that's going to come down on Kevin Sullivan. So I would say that the man made a very smart move, Gordon Sully. I would definitely say that he made a smart move by sending a telegram and realizing the ways of his errors of his ways and not show up today.
Well, I'm faced with another problem now because Friday night, Austin Idol and Kevin Sullivan are...
That's right. Wait just a second, Gordon.
That's at the Omni.
You forgot about tonight in Griffin, baby. We're going to be getting down tonight in Griffin and then tomorrow night in Marietta. But the Omni, it don't look like that Kevin Sullivan or ever what his name is going to have a partner. But you know, I heard Jack Briscoe out here shooting his mouth off, man, saying he'd give him a hand. Well, let me tell you something, Jack Briscoe. You're going to have to get through me first, boy, and that's going to be hard to do. You can bet your money on it, baby.
Thank you.